Get started here. Kind of waiting for. I'm checking Twitch to see if the bitrate catches up before I actually really start drawing. I'm also gonna wait for some more people to trickle in. But in the meantime, I'm going to get a prompt ready for monster making. Okay. Trying to decide if I want to just combine two animals together, two normal animals to make a strange creature. It's kind of what I'm leaning towards. One of the last times I used unique or mythical creature prompt, and it gave me the names of like monsters that kind of exist in like mythology. But it's not exactly what I was looking for in prompt ideas. So I think I'm just gonna just pick two random animals. and combine them together to make probably a very weird looking creature. So I'm just gonna go ahead and create a new canvas. Okay, what kind of animal are we doing? So jellyfish and a dog. Okay. So a jellyfish dog. That would probably end up being really cute. Jelly dog. Yes, exactly. Let me get that in the written up on the screen here. Okay. Do a guide layer this time. Take a look at some references of jellyfish real quick. I have a general idea of what a typical jellyfish looks like, but I know there's different kinds. Okay. Okay. I think I have an idea of something. I think I'm just gonna, oh, this is the wrong tool. There we go. Start with the, oh, and that's the wrong color of ink. I guess I'll start with a general jellyfish shape. Yeah, that's definitely. That's definitely going to be made smaller. Thank you. Trying to think now of what kind of dog breed to mix with this.
Thank you.
Okay. That's a pretty good first draft. Decrease that brush a bit. The size of the brush, I mean. That's a happy looking little flop doodle. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going away from the original head shape that I drew on the guide. Like mainly 'cause I don't know, I feel like I drew the head a little weird there. I would assume a dog that is also a jellyfish would be pretty happy with life. Every so often I have to take a look at the, how the outline is doing without the guide. Just to make sure I'm on the right track with how things turn out. Ugh. That sucks. I colored on the wrong layers. Now I have to redo all that. Think for the as just a side note for the jellyfish tentacles down here, I think I'm just gonna not really erase all of the pink that overlaps the lines necessarily. Just because jellyfish tentacles are so like they're really like wavy and not very like solid, if you know what I mean. So I feel like having that wavy bit of color that kind of like goes on the outside a lot, the ink lines, is probably not too much of a bad thing in my mind. I am seeing spots on the tentacles that I missed with color, so I'm gonna see. Fix those up. Yeah, right here. And here. It's missing. Yeah, there's. Getting rid of the white background really helps to see spots that I missed painting. I'll allow it. Okay, thank you. Shading here. I think that's on. It's on detail. No, it's not on details. It's on color. Okay. In here somewhere. Oh, it was Blur, wasn't it? Maybe. Maybe if I turn it into an airbrush. Oh, that kind of adds a blend to it. The lines won't be as harsh. Supposed to be solid. Okay. I think kind of want to add some color to the background. I've been trying to mess with backgrounds lately. Just because I want to get a better at it. Thank you. I'll just leave it with a gradient background. Jellyfish don't really like stay around the well, actually I can't say that. I don't know where jellyfish swim in the water, if they're up more towards the surface or closer to the seafloor. I'm not sure, but I'll just leave this one staying kind of in the in between, if you will. So, yeah, there's a jellyfish dog. All right, I wanna do, excuse me. I apologize if my voice sounds gross. I came down with a sore throat and a cough earlier this week, so, so I'm just healing from that. So I'm gonna sound a little bit gross, unfortunately. The next creature, I wanna, instead of trying to combine two regular animals, maybe I should try to combine two different mythical creatures. I'm not sure how well that would work out, but I'm gonna roll the dice and see what I get. Looks like I got, so the first one is ogre, and the other is a jackalope. Okay. Jackalopes, aren't those like the like rabbits with antlers? Jackalope. Oh, I didn't spell that right. Is this supposed to be a mythical creature? For some reason, I keep feeling like I heard that these were real. Jackalopes, I mean. I'll allow it also. Okay, thank you. I also just did a new roll on the combining two animals idea, and I got peacock and bear. I could probably think of something with those two animals. Let me change our prompt down here. Peacock bear. The wild pea bear. Instead of the wild Pooh Bear. Let me get a new canvas going. Okay. I'll just do the same thing as I did last time and just make a guide layer and brainstorm on that. Okay. I just got a notification for something. Oh, thank you, Give Him the Dirty, for the follow. Oh wow, that actually means, if I'm correct, we just hit our goal of 5 followers. Woo! Yeah, thank you for the follow. I gotta change that. That meter now to be the next goal. Let's see. I'll probably fix that before the next stream. Okay. Twitch is just alerting me of the follower goal met. It was a little bit slow on the notification. But yeah, awesome. I'm not used to that alert going off. It jump scares me. Every time. Kind of want to Is it gonna keep alerting until I do something about the ghoul? I think I'll just go ahead and maybe change that here real quick. Can I start a new? Yeah, 10 should be 10 would work. Maybe. Well, actually, I don't know. I'll wait. I don't want there to be too much of nothing going on screen.
Go.
How's the volume on the music going? I feel like it's getting too loud. I'm just gonna turn that down a little bit. Peacock feathers look. Okay. Oh man. I forget sometimes how big peacock plumes are when they like stretch their tail feathers like all the way. Might take up most of my canvas. Thank you. Drop my pen. Thank you. Almost forgot how to spell. I guess I was wrong. I guess peacock legs aren't really yellow. They're almost kind of flesh colored. I change that. Part that I'm a bit nervous to try is the pattern on the peacock feathers. Okay. I have a general idea of what they look like. Oh, that's an easier. I just found an image that just has a single feather. A single peacock feather, and what the pattern looks like, so that'll help me a lot. Let's see. As I am coloring in each individual feather, I am realizing this is probably gonna take me another stream to finish. At least finish it to a point where I'm like satisfied with it. And right now it's not near Not near satisfactory in my book for being finished. So I think I'm going to leave this, leave him as he is here and come back to him. I plan to do another Monster Maker stream. I'll most likely do that on Monday. And which would be perfect timing because it's the start of Halloween season, spooky season. So yeah, I think I'll come back to him on Monday and try to finish him, and then maybe start on another monster. But I think for now, I am just gonna go ahead and call it a night. Before I go, I just want to say thank you to everyone who tuned in and who follow my stream, my channel. It means a lot to me. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the stream tonight. I thought it was a lot of fun. But for now, I'm gonna tune out. Thank you guys again for watching. And have a good night.